Hey, what's up, you guys? Crap Farms here. Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. So we are going to haul another load. We are in Great Falls, Montana. Let's see here. So this is our highest priced. Got dry milk, a frac tank from Great Falls to Billings. We just made that. So we got Great Falls to Butte. With cans or waste paper. Oil pipes. Let's run dry milk from Great Falls out to Bozeman for $8,287. It's going to be a decent trip. Can I adjust articulated trailers and delivery heavy cargo? Let's take a look here and see what we got for a trailer. Like we're going to be in a different truck today. So again with triples. Goodness. And we are in a Mack truck. Well, let's get on out of here. Was hoping to not be pulling triples again, but so be it, I guess. And I think we're going out the wrong way, but we're gonna make her work. Let me out. Yes, it is. Perfect. Got 242 miles, so basically about the same length of a trip as we had yesterday, which is quite funny. See nobody coming out of them gates there. Not a fan of this truck whatsoever. I prefer sticking to my Peterbilts and Kenworths, which is mostly what our fleet is going to consist of come the time that we start running our own fleet. Our truck is definitely going to be a Peterbilt, and we're going to have our truck completely decked out. My end goal, once we have our own company and we're running our own truck and we have our own trailers, is I plan on our three main trailers being a hopper bottom, a cattle pod, and a either low boy or flatbed. Something along them lines. We're probably going to do a lot of cattle trucking. We are just speeding on through. Yikes, I got to cut it close. Episode today. Whoops. Bit. That's my bad. Thought this was the turn. Our turn is right here. That is my bad. At least, no harm there. Thank you. speed limit. Oh. Easy there, guy. Oh no. Okay, I lost a bunch of his stuff. Must have had a good sized wreck. Now this definitely is looking a lot like some Montana area. Let's take a look here, just because I'm curious. Let's see, do they have... I believe it's Glendive. That, yep, I-94. I know that interstate all too well. Then it, yep, then it comes into Billings and turns into I-90. I-94 is what runs through my hometown. I live, I should say, I guess. It's not really my hometown, but where I currently call home for the most part. And this girl is gonna just struggle to pull this load. Have to play around with this a little bit on one of my other save games on this steering sensitivity and see if I can get it dialed in a little bit better for next weekend. So you guys will have to let me know what you think, if you guys kind of like changing it up a little on the weekends and throwing in some other stuff. I might throw in other videos too at times. But this is going to be kind of our main weekend series. But there may be some weekends where on one of the days I throw in a longer video of something. Excuse me. You know, I throw in some other random video, whether it be Farm Sim or some other game even, maybe. Just to kind of expand, you know, or broaden our gameplay a little bit. Farm Sim is going to remain our main game, but something just to kind of switch it up at times. Give us something a little bit different. While we're thinking of it here, let's take a look here. So we're going to go straight through Helena, and then we'll come down here, loop around onto I-90. We'll come into Bozeman and straight over to the freight company. So a fairly straightforward drive today. We don't have a lot of in town. We don't have a lot of constant turning like we did yesterday. Hopefully our next load that we get isn't a set of triples for once. Kind of getting tired of that. These triples are a pain in the ass to try and turn. That really makes some wide corners. Stop right here, and we're gonna grab us a screenshot. 159 miles to go. One thing I definitely like better about the Peterbilts and the Kenworths in this game. That, and in real life, my preferred trucks are my main truck is Peterbilt, but I don't mind the some Kenworths either. Speed limit drops to 70, but the truck speed limit stays the same. Definitely like to see the Dakotas added to this eventually, to see North and South Dakota, especially North Dakota, because that's where I am. It'd be kind of neat to see my home state on here. This truck is just struggling to pull this big load. Get her. Montana's got some intense hills, so that'd be another thing that'd be kind of neat about having the Dakotas in here is having the Black Hills of South Dakota. That would be fun to see on here. Truck through those. Butte, Montana. Definitely want to slow down for this sharp curve here. Seven miles till we are at our delivery point. start building some speed again. Make it up this hill.3 miles. Perfect. We're riding the strips a little bit there. Oh well. I'd rather be riding these rumble strips on the edge than be riding in the center. Take out a car. Have them hit us. There, down to 25 miles. Perfect. Must be a train track underneath of us. Ah, shoot, we went the wrong way. Whoops. How that was set up there. Let's take a look here. So it's gonna have us go all the way down here and then backtrack. Well, shit. Now we just added another 50 miles onto our trip. If only they had better directions. Made it seem like we had to curve with the road. Not. Oh, well, that's all right. Pull off on the next exit and flip around and make our way back. Get her. mile to our exit. Exit. Flipped around here and head back. Guardrail. Lucky I'm making a left there, bud. That would have been a bad day. All right, 40 miles. Let's get this knocked out. It was this nice in Farm Sim to do things in first person. That would make the game a lot more fun, but it's very difficult to do a lot of things in first person like this in Farm Sim. Not screw up this time and get the right exit. Otherwise, we gotta go through town, and that would be a royal pain in the ass. Trying to get turned around inside this town. No, thank you. First exit we're taking. That's the way we gotta get out of here. There we go. Oh, we're getting her figured out. Car dealership. Mechanic shop, it looks like. They're all the way down here on the end. Yeah, no. We are not going to make that corner. So we're just going to do it the quick way. So we got 500 experience points, and we got $8,287. We got a $78 proficiency bonus. And so we are now a level 2. Let's add to our high value. Apply. Let's see what the bank wants, because I'm sure... we are looking for a skilled driver with their own trucks. Well, we can't do that. That is out of, that is from GF Cargo in Great Falls. Let's take a look once here. Back in Great Falls. But anyways, we are down here in Bozeman, and, looks like they got a decent load that we can grab next weekend and make some more money. So that's gonna do it, folks. Hope y'all enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to smash that thumbs up button, and as always, folks, we'll see y'all tomorrow.